So hello everybody, my name is Kimo Olep and I'm from Estonia and I'm going to show you how our team created a map editing solution for Omniva employees to build the geographic areas which are perfectly editable without creating host slices or topology exceptions. So I want to ask you, raise your hands who are involved in web mapping editing solutions, developers or anything, or? Okay, good. Little bit about Omniva. Omniva is an international post and logistics company based in Tallinn, Estonia, with the entire Baltic states as its domestic market. Omniva Group is 5 companies. From the Baltics, has employees around 2,300 and is the leader of parcel terminal market in Baltic. I myself am not Omniva employee, but an outsourced GIS expert to solve Omniva geoinformatic problems and to build solutions. So, client. Client wants to build geographical areas that they can constantly change. In case of our client Omniva, they need to constant changing because they need to daily logistics planning, which include managing addresses, adjusting parcel machine areas when overloading occur, planning courier routes, and so on. So when we have logistics who have business logic in their head and when they have great vision how to solve some geospatial task like organizing parcel machine areas or managing courier routes are created, then creating application where we can't rely on geoinformatic and acknowledge is a must. Wait a second. I'm a little bit stuck here. There is also a way to teach them to use already existing geospatial editing tools like cookies. But then it's a training expense and mostly those people are not so excited about it. That's mostly because of learning curve takes time and they don't trust themselves when it comes to critical use of data. So we started to build application with business logic where all the validations are made inside the workflow and to build user-friendly interface where we gave user functionality that won't confuse them. And we all know how it's typically going. The most basic way to let user to create errors is to enable polygon drawing tool and then adding all business logic behind it, like how does overlappings are accepted or what region is allowed to edit at all. And after enabling drawing tool, user would also like to have slicing tool to cut existing errors to pieces. And that's not all. User would also like to have merge tool to union errors back together. And also, if there is a regard to have fully covered errors by region, use function that validates created shapes and show to user where are the holes. With this editing solution, user quickly runs into cases where slices come up, little holes, overlappings where it's not accepted, and the worst topology exceptions. Which means that we still need person who have geoinformatic knowledge to clean up the mess. And this is not the way we are going to solve problems. There are some examples I have made up here. There are a little bit slices there in the purple area, and also this polygon topology misbehaviors. So we started to share solution, how basic user can create errors without going into depths of geoinformatic systems, but can create errors that will cover all business logic requirements and are easy to modify. And user can actually understand how geographic errors are made without creating geographical mess of data. We went to create blocks. Blocks are geographical representations of pre-generated errors, which we made out of using different site layers like settlement unit borders, road, network railways, river center lines and cadastral parcels were applicable. Using those layers, we put them all together and sliced with each other. And the result is approximately 2.5 million shapes that covers Baltic states land and water areas. In the cities, we have usually small surface blocks. And on the countryside or on the water areas, we have bigger surface blocks. But all Baltic states are now covered side by side from border to border. And this is the example of Baltic states. And it's rotated. On the left, right side is Estonia, and on the left side is Lithuania. Smaller blocks are mostly about half square meters, and biggest ones are about 1,500 hectares, kilometers, and that's mostly in the sea. From now on, we created web user interface where we have only those blocks visible. But user can add different classifications to the block, which defines how user wants to draw wire. This means that user never modifies spatial shape itself, but instead selects multiple blocks and sends to database. And here you can see purple lines to represent block borders. Red line is drawn by user with drawing tool by freehand using snapping tool to snap with the road layer. And the blue line now represents how aggregated blocks are created. There is not much difference. Here you can see example when layer snapping is not used or were not accessible, which means that every movement must be made carefully. And this is a lot of digitizing on daily basis. Also, it's hard to validate the result. Now in the database, we collect all block IDs. Request all those block shapes and union them all together. And because of block shapes are topologically correct, then the union of them is error-free and perfectly merged together. This is how merged array will look that have been created out of blocks. And this is how blocks identifiers array look like. For example, covering 5,000 square kilometers of land array takes about 50,000 blocks, but it depends on location. In the cities, it would be much more, and countryside, of course, less. Block holds very basic information. It has identifier that will be used to create arrays, and it has its own shape that we hold in database in World Geodetic System 84. We are also transforming block shapes into Estonian national coordinate system on the application side because of use of Estonian land port base layers, which are not usable in World Geodetic System. When using approach where user is digitizing arrays and slicing and uniting them, there will be more problem when transforming coordinates because of coordinate flow error will create topological misbehaviors. Block has relations with classifications that can be made out of anything. This gives us very much information where it belongs to, and this information can be requested without making spatial requests. Some examples that we are currently using, addresses, zip codes, servicing areas. For example, when there is one block has been selected to multiple courier areas, each weekday might be serviced by different courier routes. If we want to know when this one block is serviced by courier today, we can easily make request without spatial processing. There is also a price tag for this block and a relation with parcel machine arrays. If there is house inside a block, then we can request how many mailboxes are in the block. Relations can be created to unlimited use cases. It is just a matter of defining classifications. And this is a great opportunity with blocks approach that we can request all the information that one block holds. For example, this is useful for providing speed performance for distribution center where packages are managed to hand out over the courier. And blocks can be sliced. This means that if there is a house built into block and this is need to be sliced, we just archive the old block and create new ones and update all the relations. Super blocks. Super blocks are a collection of blocks which have been pre-generated to be shown on upper scales where rendering each block will affect performance. Superblock can be created out of any collection. We did build them using settlements, but there is no reason to just create them out of square kilometers of grid. User can now on select superblocks and add some individual blocks. And in the database, we aggregate superblock shapes with individual block shapes. This will give faster performance on when visualizing on map and also when aggregating in database. Now let's go to the application we built. There is some animation GIF. So blocks benefits are that we can easily show from application how the areas are made. Where are the overlaps, which means that one block have more than one same classification parameter, or if there is no classification parameter specified, then this block is unused, and this means we don't have full coverage for these classifications. Let me give you some awesome examples which are with this approach. For example, it is easy to restrict blocks that can be used when drawing area, and user will only have some specific region to modify. Another good example is that we have defined zip code areas into blocks. In application, we can let user to use only zip codes to build up new layer from it. When zip code area changes, then all relatives will change along. Another example, when user creates overlapping, then it's easy to show where did it happen. And now user can decide to remove this overlapping from editing area or to remove it from the area that were below editing area. This is the red area is showing the overlapping, and it can be removed from the below or from the editing area. And there is no overlapping after all. And there is much more ways to use block approach. It's just a matter of imagination. About technology we used. To solve this approach, we used GeoServer to serve vector tiles in Mapbox vector tile format for rendering blocks in open layers. And on the open layers, when user creates area, the vector tile feature is tiled on the fly. When user selects or deselects blocks, there is no request to the backend in these cases. But we do use web feature service currently. If user wants to select blocks with rubber band tool, that's because vector tiles in open layers didn't have proper way to filter them out. Web application itself is built with React and Redux State Manager, which provides fast performance on rendering user interface. So on the backend, we use the Spring Boot microservices architecture along with RabbitMQ message exchange system. And for the database, we had to use SQL Server because of Omnia architecture requirements. And on the background, we use more technologies that will help us to solve data management or to build up services. Usually, all the data preparing is made up with Postgres SQL and PostGIS instances because of simplicity of writing queries that SQL Server can't handle, or it requires too much writing. And actually, I'm finished now. It went much faster than I tried to at home. thank you. So we have more time to ask questions about this.
You used roads and rivers and everything to cut the blocks.
Yeah.
How did you get center lines for the roads, or did you or did you use like double lines if it was a dual carriageway?
Mostly double lines are centered to the between them. I think it's not. There is a Dennis here, who is my colleague, who is making this data processing. You can ask from him later about this. I myself am more like a front-end developer and all this architecture.
Really nice what you did with all these blocks, and it looks to me that that would also be a great opportunity to put in some linked data. Did you consider that, or did you think of that?
Linked data between making relations with them, or what? What do you mean about linked data?
Well, with linked data, you can like keep on adding links or relations to separate blocks in your case to combine with external data sources or like even your internal ones. So it comes to me as a great opportunity to put in linked data as well.
But right. I'm not aware of this.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you for listening.
So it looks to me that the user is kind of adding links to the blocks. Is that what the users actually do, or what does the user do with the software?
With blocks.
With the software.
With the software, user is creating arrays. Like currently, it's probably a partial machine array what it's doing, but there is also those courier routes. What is measured? How courier is traveling? And also, when partial machine arrays, if there is overload in partial machine, then they shrink this array to smaller. And the hole, which is left over, it's been used to redirect to other partial machine array.
Sorry, I think there was a question in the back here.
Hi, yeah, a question about just the process of creating the blocks. Like how clean, or how did you prioritize like how clean that data set was? Like if you had these different data sets and they also didn't overlap precisely and made little slivers and left kind of like artifacts in those blocks, did you care about that? Did you try and clean that up, or was that not that important?
We used different data sets, also OpenStreetMap data, and also in Estonia we used land board data. And it's quite clean, and it can be more. I lost my word. let's ask later. Let's talk about it later.
So, did you also make some tools for the customers to find where the misselections? Like if the client makes the area and there's one parcel or one block that's missed, like it's in wrong zone. Did you make any tools for finding that one small block in the that should not be there?
It's quite hard actually to detect what should not to be selected into error, which block is not well configured. We can show where are the leftovers, like which block is not selected, but and also where are the overlappings. But for defining like where this block is not correctly selected, it's quite hard.
Okay.
As I understand, you use GeoServer for background services and also generating vector tiles.
Yes.
Did you encounter any performance issues with vector tiles generated by GeoServer?
We're running about 2.5 million blocks, and they're actually running quite fastly. There is no performance issues. More issues is about rendering on map.
Well, yeah, because they are related.
No, somehow.
Yeah, because in my experience, it's hard to fine-tune vector tiles generated by GeoServer.
Okay.
They became too big to render fastly. But if you didn't have any performance issues, it's good.
Yeah, that's why also we created super blocks to cover those areas where vector tiles blocks are making are going too small. Then they are not rendered at all. And if we are styling this on the map, it's really easy to see where are the holes are making. But when you're zooming in, then you can see that these blocks are all already selected. But super blocks will cover it.
Any additional questions?
I just thinking, how many blocks are there?
2.5 million blocks in Baltic states.
All right, well, thank you very much.